Yucatan High School in Hampton. WHES Cable Channel 5 presents Peninsula District Boys Basketball. The Kecoughtan Warriors hosting the Hampton Crabbers. Good evening, everybody. I'm Tim Cole, along with Bob Hintz. We welcome you to Kecoughtan High School for this battle between the Warriors at 0-12 and the Hampton Crabbers at 10-3. Right now, let's go to center court. Bob Hintz has head coach Remus Conrad of the Kecoughtan Warriors.
Well, coach, you've played the number four teams, the two that are tied, 1-1 overtime and lost it, and then last night to a double overtime and lost it. When your kids play together, they play well.
They played very well last night. I was sorry that they lost, but overall, they really did a great job. They came back from two very bad defeats against Hampton and Phoebus, and Phoebus, they just ran us out of our own gym. But last night, they played very well.
Well, you're a young team, and hopefully they're going to get some experience that's going to help you at least next year.
Yeah, well, they're getting experience, but they need the experience to win right now real bad.
Well, listen, good luck to you tonight, Coach.
Thank you very much.
Okay, good enough. Let's run back over to Tim.
All right, thank you, Bob. Of course, Remus Conrad, his squad 0-12, and not a good season for them, but I'll tell you something, it's not because of a lack of effort. These young men try hard and have shown it on every game that we have seen, and they'll come up with a win sooner or later here. All right, let's go back to Bobby as head coach Walter Brower of the Hampton Crabbers.
Walter, we finally get you guys on TV. This is a game we was going to do earlier, but we had to change it because of the football. But you guys are really right next to the door on number one.
Well, I felt the race would be tight all along, and it was just a matter of us regrouping, getting the right combinations in there, and I felt we'd do all right.
Well, you're getting some help from teams that a lot of people didn't think do very well. Bethel's playing real well. Phoebus is playing well. So this is just not a two-team league this year.
No, Phoebus is tough. They're going to beat a lot of people, and I don't even want to think about going into Bethel to play.
That's a tough gym to play on, isn't it?
It really is. Breon's done a heck of a job.
Well, listen, congratulations on a good start. And keep it going, and good luck to you tonight.
Thanks.
Good enough, Walter. Okay, Tim, let's go back to you.
All right, thank you, and our congratulations go to Walter Brower, his squad 10-3, coming off of a 74-59 victory at Denby last night. Friday night, Ronald Curry paced the Crabbers with 26 points. Bobby Blizzard had 24 points for the Hampton Crabbers. On the other side, Remus Conrad trying to overcome that double overtime loss to Heritage. He had 22 points from Kier Limford.
Right, we get that pronunciation right.
Kier Limford. And Ben Douglas had 17 for his squad. But, you know, when you're Remus Conrad and you're used to winning because he's had a great program here at Kecoughtan, I can see on his face and in his voice, they need to win real badly. It's one thing to keep playing well, and that's fine, but there's nothing quite like winning, as you said.
No, and it really does. And, Tim, you got to go back to not having a true point guard, and not having that true point guard has really hurt this team. He's got some real good athletes, but he doesn't have somebody that can step up, be the quarterback on the court. As you know, very, very important. You may not score a lot of points or anything else, but just running the offense, running the defense gives the rest of the kids a lot of confidence, and they do. They do need a win. It would really help, and this would be a tremendous upset if they could win tonight.
It's tough. You and I talked about it the last time they had back-to-back games, which was just last week. It's hard to get your squad up on the second night, not because of the fact that you need to be motivated. It's just tough physically to play back-to-back when you're not used to it.
And you really aren't, and then you had the whole week off because of exams, and so you probably didn't practice at the same time that you normally practice. Big difference.
All right, here's your starters. Chris Weeks for Hampton, number 14. Aaron Chambliss, number 20. Aaron Chambliss now being introduced. Ronald Curry.
And don't forget our buddy Bobby Blizzard.
Johnny Story and Bobby Blizzard round out the starting five for the 10-3. Hampton Crabbers under head coach Walter Brower. There you see the starters for the Crabbers. Our first look at this young team. Now for the Kecoughtan Warriors, Remus Conrad. Byron Jernigan is the guard to start for Remus. Marshall Haggard gets the start tonight, number 21.
Marlon Hicks,
number 40, the big wide body. Co-captain Ben Douglas, number 34. And the other co-captain, Pierre Lipford, number 32 for the Kickatan Warriors.
Well, they got to have Marlon Hicks in there, Tim, because they're going up against a pretty good front line that they have over there, led by Bobby Blizzard. And there you can see the Warriors, the starters. You got to have somebody that's going to put a little muscle, a little body, a little weight, take up some space in there, not letting the Crabbers get a lot of offensive rebounds. And of course, we got our buddy Jim Downey right here in front of him with the ball. And I'd asked, as you see the other officials, Bill Wessel and Bob Cockrell, but I asked Bill, I said, I noticed you got some gum. I said, when you blow the whistle, does it ever get stuck in it? He just laughed at me. I think they get rid of it. But they get dry mouths just like everybody else. This is exciting, as you had mentioned earlier.
And these are three of the better officials on the peninsula, Wessel, Cockrell, and Downey, and that only cost them $5 for the No, they are.
They do a great job.
They do. And these officials, you and I will occasionally question the call, but they do a real fine job, and you don't have enough money for me to be one of them.
I couldn't do it.
All right, we're about set to get this one underway. The only jump ball of the ball game will be orchestrated by the referee, Jim Downey. Hampton's number 32, Bobby Blizzard, will go against his like number, Kier Lipford, and it's controlled by the Crabbers and knocked out of bounds on a good defensive effort to prevent a sure two.
Well, that was a set play off of the jump ball, but Marshall Haggard got back and got a hand on the ball.
The Crabbers, Ronald Curry, down low, shot is good.
That's Bobby Blizzard. You talk about a nice young man. I tell you, I just enjoy talking to him. He's very friendly, very outgoing.
Hicks had it, lost it, but it was last touched by a Crabber.
Hampton zoning on the inbounds.
Haggard gets it in to Lipford, and he scores. So the 32s on your score column each contribute a basket early in the going. Ronald Curry.
So quick. He gets down there before the defense has a chance to set up.
And talk about getting quickly. There is no shot clock. And there are 8 minutes in each of the four quarters in high school basketball. And other than that, the rules are pretty much the same.
And you see what's happening is Hampton is in a man-to-man, and they're just going to power you. And, of course, you got somebody who can rebound and bring the ball down the court like Ronald Curry, and he creates a lot of offensive sets.
Foul is called against Jernigan. Revis felt it went the other way, but didn't get the call. And Johnny Story, number 30, will go to the free throw line. Watch the replay. And that could have been a block, but it was called the other way, or rather a charge, I should say, and it was called a block.
Tim, this young man's on the foul line, just a freshman. Broke into this starting lineup and is doing a great job. Walter Brower, very impressed with this young man.
Well, don't you love to have a freshman starting for you? That means you got him for 4 years and you can watch him grow.
And you know if he's good now, that if he works hard and continues, that he's going to get better.
And he hits both free throws, and it's a four-point Hampton lead.
And Ham just playing a straight-up man-to-man, picking him up about three-quarter court.
This is Jernigan to Lipford. He is double-teamed, gets it back to Jernigan.
Well, they double-team on the sideline. Ronald Curry just left his man and went over to double-team.
In the corner, Jernigan. Guarded by Chambliss, and an offensive foul is called against Jernigan. So he picks up two fouls early here.
Well, and not only that, Tim, but if it had a foul gone the other way, he'd got the basket and been on the foul line.
Yep. So take away the two-point basket and credit the foul against Jernigan, his second. Ronald Curry picked up by Marshall Haggard. Curry kicks it out to Story, and he has it taken away momentarily. Chambliss in the corner, all the way back outside, swinging the ball around. Curry for three, short. And the loose ball cannot hold on to it. Lipford had it, but couldn't get a hold of the handle.
Sometimes, Tim, when you're a team that is struggling and you play a good team like that, you raise your method of playing, but you also sometimes get a little too anxious. and you can't find the handle, and that happened that time as we had a turnover, it looks like.
It was a jump ball as Hicks did a good job underneath the basket to tie up the Crabber, and the possession arrow gave it back to the Warriors. So with 6:12 left here in the first, Warriors down by four. Lipford. Jernigan picked up by Chambliss. Haggard on the screen is open, now penetrates, tries to get it to Hicks. They kick it back out to Jernigan. He's wide open from 14 and hits it.
And that, you got to hit that, Chuck, because you're not going to be very often, you're not going to have a free look like that.
6-4 Hampton. Ball is knocked out of bounds, and it goes off of the Hampton Crabbers. Johnny Story lost it. Hampton 10-3 in second place behind Menchville. Menchville suffering the loss last night at the hands of the Bethel Bruins. With a victory tonight, the Crabbers can get a tie for first. Ball was kicked out of bounds. I believe they're going to say it still belongs to the Warriors.
Yeah, I think it went off of one of the Crabbers, number 14. I believe it went off of his, that's Chris Weeks, went off his foot.
So Marshall Haggard will get the ball at the top of the key, picked up by Blizzard. Lipford thought about shooting, now gives back to Haggard.
And Hampton is doing a lot of switching. Bobby Blizzard is on Haggard that time.
Lipford has it partially blocked. The Crabbers want to run with it. They get it to Curry. Curry's hammered. He'll get two shots. Curry and Hicks, no strangers to each other.
I met a few times with, they had a little more pads on.
Here's the replay. You're going to see the quick outlet pass. Curry chases it down and then goes to the basket and is knocked hard on a good clean foul, but a hard foul. All right, Mr. Baton doesn't get to wear any pads down there, and he was in no man's land there for a minute as our cameraman was in harm's way, but got him out of the way, and we're glad to say. One of two free throws, 3-point lead for the Crabbers. Haggard thought about driving, now kicks it out for Jernigan. Jernigan to Lipford. Lipford had to do a tightrope walk to keep it on the far baseline. Douglas, Lipford. Lipford shadowed by Ronald Curry.
Well, I thought they were doing some switching, but Bobby Blizzard is playing Marshall Haggard, and he's playing a guard, and that's quite a... an accomplishment for somebody as big as he is at 6'5", 6'6", that can defend the guard as well as he's doing.
Good job by Curry to tie the ball up. And on the possession arrow, the Crabbers get it back. Up by three, Curry to Blizzard in the lane, left-handed hook shot, no good.
Nice move, nice spin move by Bobby. Just didn't get the stick back, or stick in, but nice move just the same.
Knocked away by Curry. Ronald Curry on the way, and he jams it home.
He can sky.
Ronald Curry, as most of our viewers would know, the quarterback on the state and, national high school championship football team.
Oh, nice shot by
Marshall Haggard for three.
I know his dad is in the stands, Jimmy Haggard.
But anyway, our congratulations to the Hampton Crabbers as being named on, what, 4 out of 5 national polls as the number one team in the country. Thank you very much. Ronald Curry had a lot to do with that. Huh. Haggard. His team down by a bucket. Ben Douglas in the corner, Haggard. And we've got contact away from the ball, and that's going to be against Hicks.
I don't know if he threw his elbow. And he got a technical.
And
that counts as another personal.
Yeah, that's the tough way to get two quick ones, and that will not make Revis Conrad happy. Get angry, just don't get mouthy. And it cost his team now. Hicks will come out and get a breather. And you mentioned right at the top of the thing, they need him in there
for
his
really do.
Bulk. And he can't do much help to the team on the bench. So the technical foul will be shot by Aaron Chambliss. Chambliss.
Just a junior, Tim.
He'll get two shots on the technical. So he hits both, and now to add insult to injury, the Crabbers will get the ball at half court.
Well, Hampton only starts one senior, and that's Weeks.
Sound like their football team.
You say, how do they do that?
Ronald Curry gets it to stay down. It started to roll out, and it went back down. Curry has seven, and his team is up by six. In the corner, Lipford has it knocked away, and it still belongs to the Warriors. A little less than 3 minutes to go here in the first period. Want to thank Wood Funeral Home, where Richard Pulley is the funeral director. Don Ware and Brian Wood on staff.
Armando Curry, number 10, checks in, and I'm trying to see who he replaced.
Looks like he came in for Chris Weeks, number 14, I think, as soon came out.
I believe you're right.
Armando Curry in the lineup now for the Crabbers, along with Chambliss. Story, this is Blizzard, and Blizzard's shot is a little too strong in the lane. Blizzard rebounds, no good. And Jernigan picks it up for the Warriors.
Now that's a tough shot. Bobby's just not getting his shoulders square to the basket.
And Douglas gets the bucket.
Nice shot by Douglas.
So the Warriors hanging tough, down by four. 2:22 left in the first period. On the baseline, shot won't go. Now it's stuck against the backboard and the rim, and that's just like a jump ball. It'll go over on the possession arrow to the Warriors. Substitution for the Crabbers, getting set to come in, is number 52. That's Jim Woodard, his first entry into the game. So watch the ball, it just ended up jammed between the rim and the backboard.
Yeah, Woodard replaces Bobby Blizzard.
Walter Brower, that's our first look at Hampton this year, but Walter Brower has never hesitated to go to his bench.
No, he hasn't.
And that served him well in the past. Wide open, shot is off the rim. Rebound comes to Story.
A nice looking freshman, isn't he? Reminds you a lot of the young man for Phoebus, Maurice Shanks, who is also a freshman.
Yeah.
They built very similar.
Couple of good looking freshmen, you're right there. Ronald Curry with the ball, the junior. Kicks it outside for Story, and he can't get it to drop from the free throw line, so the 15-footer is no good. And hit from behind, Chambliss will be called for the foul, his first.
I tell you, Kickitan is hanging right in there. They're playing tough. They could, you could just kind of sit back and say, well, I know they're a better team as we watch the replay, and they're gonna beat us anyway, but they're not, they're fighters.
Player control foul with a minute 32 remaining in the first period. In the ball game now, number 14, Robbie Simmons. And Woodard with the rebound. Remember Woodard from last year.
Yeah.
Ronald Curry pulls up, off balance shot, drops down, and Curry slides all the way to half court. Lost his balance and used slick floor here to slide about 15 feet.
He just polished the floor for him. Yeah. Tim, we will pick a player of the game for both of these teams, and they will receive a shirt and a plaque. The plaque comes from Buckwalter Engraving, located at Kickitan Road. For all your engraving needs, contact Jim at 723-6067. Dave Buckwalter is the owner, and the shirt comes from the Island of Hardware and Sporting Goods, located in Pocosin. They can meet all your sports needs with a full line of athletic goods, both team and individual, equipment and uniforms, plus screen printing. Call Dave Chubb at 868-8467. John Roberts is owner.
Another Hampton well-known name from the basketball or the football squad, Martin Tinsley, has checked in for Hampton as Pierre Lipford scores two. Back the other way.
Oh, nice pass from Ronald Curry that time to Woodard. I didn't think he would be able to get it in there, but nice little short bounce pass got it in there.
Let me see if I got this right. You didn't think Ronald Curry could get a pass to someone? That's Curry, fouled from behind. He'll get a pair. Foul will be charged against Simmons.
Yeah, I don't know why that doesn't surprise me.
Watch the replay here. You're going to see the steal, the lead pass, and there's the foul. So that's a good foul. You don't foul that player, and he gets the easy two. So you make him go to the free throw line. Jernigan checks out of the game. In comes Well, I don't have a number 10 for Kikutan. Do you know who number 10 is? Did we have the same problem last time?
Nope.
Well, we'll see what we can find out. Anyway, Ronald Curry with a couple. 19 to 11. Woodard is stuffed on the play. The ball goes out of bounds off of Hampton.
We'll try to find out who number 10 is, Tim. I don't have him.
Coming right at you. Watch this. Tough defense. Woodard with the rejection, and the buzzer will sound to end the first period. So the Kikutan Warriors and the Hampton Crabbers, after one, Hampton 19 and Kikutan 11. Of those 19 points, Ronald Curry has 11.
And he gets them so
quickly, effortlessly.
Yeah, right? Watch some of the replay here. What a marvelous athlete this young man is, and to be on the peninsula, to be able to see him play is that's a good block. You know, it just, you can't explain it to other people who don't live or have never seen this young man play. When I tell them how good he is, they just look at me like, you know, you making this up? I said, you got to see some of the films.
There's the block by Woodard as we watch some other replay action. And we're about set to come back to the live action. There you see intricate part of that football team in the middle of your picture, Danny Mitchell.
Oh, good shot of Danny. That's his young son, Matthew, with his back to us.
He's got to have a football uniform on.
Oh, he's not only has a football uniform, but he also has a baseball uniform that he wears.
Oh, okay.
But I've not seen him with a basketball outfit. So I guess he's a two-sport player.
You've seen a number of pictures of Matthew over the season, the football season.
We want to thank our fans right next to us. William Porter's number 10, Tim.
All right, and Ronald Curry adds two more to his total. So William Porter, we appreciate that information. We got a foul on number 22 of the Crabbers. That is Curry, that's his first. Curry's had a little bit of foul trouble this year. And he's also had some injury problems.
I talked to Elvis Mann about that. He went up on a slam guy and got kind of out of balance and came down on his hip and his shoulder, and had almost like a hip pointer. It really was a bruised hip for missed couple games, I believe.
Lipford again for three off the mark. And I would imagine Mike Smith and half the football team held their breath when they saw that happen. Of course, Curry, hopefully for Hampton faithful, to lead the Crabbers next year in his senior year. Love that comment from the James Madison coach that said he hopes he comes out early.
Yeah.
Back come the Crabbers. Chambliss with a pair off the glass.
Oh, nice body control that time by Aaron.
Crabbers up by seven. Porter gets it across the timeline. 6:20 left here in the first half. 23-16 in favor of the Crabbers. Shot won't go down, and the loose ball is picked up by Chambliss. Spots Curry on the right wing. Curry, no good, as he got too far underneath the basket.
Yeah, it looked like his hand hit the rim.
Blocked at the other end of the court as Bobby Blizzard rejects the shot.
Well, Kikutan's got four substitutes trying to get in the ball game.
Chambliss to Blizzard for two. 9-point lead by Hampton. Porter will try for three. It's off the mark. Loose ball underneath, and it's taken by the Crabbers, but he was standing on the end line. That was Blizzard. Now that stoppage of play will allow the wholesale substitution to occur. Jernigan will come back in the game for Pinkerton. Brian Walter will make his first appearance. Ben Douglas back in. Let's see who else has come back in for Pinkerton.
You got number 44 came in.
Brian Walter, Willie Sherman is in there. That's Walter off the mark. And the rebound cleared by Chris Weeks. That's where the Weeks came from. I was trying to tell you earlier, the girls game.
Oh, is that where it came from?
Yeah,
oh, okay. Yeah, I hear you, Tim.
Well, I knew I saw Weeks subliminally.
Oh, come on now. I ain't buying this.
Well, there's...
It's like when you tell officials that you don't complain about them.
That's right. Chambliss for three. So Chambliss now has 7 points. And the lead is 12, 28-16. Marshall Haggard. And Douglas, top of the key. Spinning move towards the baseline. Put it up. No good. Curry with the rebound. Say Ronald Curry, as Almondo Curry has been in and out of the game here. Stolen. This is Ben Douglas. Will he do the ham? No, he doesn't hammer it home. He just kind of laid it in there.
He was thinking about it.
Yeah, he was. And Jernigan, oh, that's a tough call.
That's three, isn't it?
Yep. Yeah, he sat with two and just picked up his third. So I'm not sure Revis Conrad, I think Richard Hall just told him about that. That's 1-1 time now,
yeah,
as it's bonus time for the Crabbers. Jernigan now with three personal fouls. I tell you, we haven't seen yet, and I don't know whether he's even here tonight, but I haven't seen him, is Joe Van Quillen.
I don't even see him on the bench, Tim.
No, I
he may be hurt.
In any event, the football quarterback for the Warriors, who has played extensively on the basketball team, not on the court and apparently not dressed out for the game. So not sure why, but in any event, to the players that are here, Aaron Chambliss hits both free throws and it gives his team a 12-point lead. Little more than 4.5 minutes to go in the first half. On the nice move, Ben Douglas can't get it to drop. Got his own rebound, no good. And Weeks.
I tell you, Walters had great block out position and Weeks just went over him and got the ball anyway.
This is Chris Weeks to Chambliss. Chambliss from 15, in and out. Stick back good by Blizzard.
And that was good, Tim. He put it back in without coming down.
That's tough to do.
It really is, but if he'd have come down, he wouldn't have got a clean shot off.
Haggard. Also a name from the Pinkerton football team to Porter.
Oh, nice shot. Nice pass by Porter. Yo, get out of here.
Ryan Walter with the two. Curry dishes, but it's stolen. Nice anticipation by Porter. Porter off the glass. Good.
I'm impressed. That's two good plays. A nice pass that caused the 2 points, and then on that steal and a drive. Ronald Curry did something that you try to tell your players not to do. Don't get up in the air and then have to make a pass. You leave your feet. You have to pass the ball to shoot. And sometimes if other players are standing still and not breaking in an opening.
In the lane, a foul is called.
And that looked like it was on 30. That'll be a story if it is.
Checking in for the Warriors is another number that we don't have a name for.
Stafford Brown.
Stafford Brown, where did I miss
52.
Him?
How come you don't have him?
I don't have him.
I got him.
Good. You can let me know about him.
He's on your sheet, Tammy.
Well, I'll have to check my sheet. Doesn't matter how I got him. I got him now. In the lane, heavy traffic, loose ball, first and 10. .251 left in the first half. Crabbers by a dozen. Here's the replay of that last action. Watch the ball got loose and then went right through the legs of the Warriors. Back to the live action. Lizard got the basket and was fouled on the play. Just like that, it happened so quickly, we didn't even get it.
It really didn't.
Lizard, chance for a three-point play. Very cool at the free throw line as the Crabbers have only missed one out of 11 free throws. They're 10 of 11 from the charity stripe. Baseline, Ben Douglas kicks it back outside. Porter tries for three. Oh, it looked good from here. Got his own long rebound. He'll try again. This is just inside the two-point lane, and it is good. Porter now with 4 points.
He's got a nice-looking shot, a good release, high arc on the ball, good follow-through.
37-24, 2:17 to go. Three-point attempt is good by Chambliss. That's his second triple.
You got to be on him. He's a shooter. He gets on a streak, and he's very dangerous.
40-24, the Crabbers showing no ill effects from playing last night as the offense is in gear. Almost stolen by Chambliss. Porter off the glass. That's the way he thought about it.
The young man who we didn't have a name for is making a name for himself.
Making a name for himself. Good point. 6 points. Ronald Curry drives the lane, and an offensive foul is called against Curry.
Just a little bit out of control that time.
Stafford Brown took the charge. So the Warriors down by 14 with a minute 42 to go.
And coming right at Mr. Baton.
Watch Ronald Curry here. He's going to move to the right of Haggard, and then it looked like Stafford Brown was still moving.
Yeah, that's a tough call to make.
Looked like he might have stepped in front of him, and that, well, anyway. Lipford's shot doesn't go. Baseline turnaround, no. Tip, yes. So Stafford Brown.
Stafford Brown put it back in.
Kick it on the offensive board.
Kick it in. Looks like at one point the game's kind of getting away from them, and then they come up with the two or three quick baskets, staying in the game.
40-28, a minute 22 remaining. Loose ball, controlled by the Crabbers. Blizzard kicks it out for Armando Curry. That is he with the ball, number 10. Blizzard. Porter, good anticipation, 3-on-2. Porter from 15, no good. And a tie-up, no, they're going to say a foul. Reach in,
yeah,
foul.
He got a little too much of the body that time. Willie Sherman, 42, is the just a sophomore. For the Crabbers, we've got some.
I got Sherman, 42, is Martin Tinsley.
Oh, I was looking at Kekatan roster. You're right,
okay.
Martin Tinsley. Young man is a pretty good little defensive back for the for that Crabber machine.
That's so little. Stick back is good. Did you see who got that?
Yeah, that was Woodard. 52.
All right, Mr. Woodard has 4 points.
A great job of getting position. You don't have the best position on the when your teammate shoots the foul shot.
From deep in the corner, it's short. Curry bumped, no foul. Haggard got it pretty good. Armando Curry out of control. Now he's guilty of the charge. Stafford Brown takes a hard seat on the floor.
Raymond Mann comes in, another freshman, Tim, 6'4". Where you get all these people?
He's 6'4", wow.
Yeah.
These boys have been hitting on the weight room, too. Ten seconds to go in the half. 14-point deficit, Stafford Brown, and he is fouled on the play, so fouled by his like number, Woodard.
Tim, I was talking to Mike Smith after the season was over, and I said, you know, you're losing a defensive end. This is a shot of Jimmy Haggard. And I said, you know, and a linebacker, and I said, it's hard to place. He said, we got a young man that played on the JV team. And I believe he said his name was Raymond Mann. I don't know if this is the same way or if I'm just picking it up. But this may be one of the young men that we'll see in uniform next year for the football team. Good-looking specimen, isn't he?
All these guys, as I said, look like they've been spending a lot of time in the weight room. Brown short on the second, but Lipford got it, can't get it to stay down, and the buzzer will sound, ending the first period. And it was a good one for the Crabbers.
It really
they
was.
Lead at halftime, 42-29. We'll return to Kingitown High School for the third period of action after this brief timeout.
Beautiful.
One of the youngest members, and if not the youngest, certainly one of the prettiest.
Well,
members.
We should call her Bright Eyes, couldn't we? Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, look at those big eyes. Well, our score at halftime is 42-29 in favor of
Matthew.
Matthew Travers. There's the young man who gets more air time than you or I do anymore.
Yep.
For the Warriors, they were paced by Pierre Lipford with 7 points. He had two baskets and a three-pointer for 7. 6 points for William Porter on 3 baskets. 4 points for Ben Douglas on a pair of baskets. And then 3 points for Stafford Brown on a basket and 1 of 2 free throws. 3 points for Marshall Haggard on a three-point shot. And then 2 points for Willie Sherman on a basket, 2 points for Brian Walter on a basket, and 2 points for Byron Jernigan, as the Warriors just had 2 free throws, hit 1 of those 2. For the Hampton Crabbers, they were led by Ronald Curry, who had 13 points in the first half. He had 5 deuces and 3 of 4 free throws. 12 points for Aaron Chambliss on a 2-point basket, 2 triples, and 4 out of 4 from the charity stripe. Bobby Blizzard had 9 points on 4 baskets and a free throw. 4 points for Jim Woodard on a pair of baskets. 2 points for Johnny Story on 2 free throws, and 2 points likewise for Chris Weeks on a basket. And the Crabbers hit 10 of 12 from the free throw line.
And we will pick a player of the game from each one of these teams, and they will receive a plaque and a shirt. The T-shirt comes from the Islander Hardware and Sporting Goods located in Pocosin, and the plaque comes from Buckwalder's Engraving, located on Kickitan Road. And we do want to thank Dave Buckwalder and John Roberts for their help in allowing us to recognize the player of the game from all the Hampton broadcasts and all Hampton teams this year.
And we encourage you to patronize those two establishments. They've been a very faithful friend, Channel 5, for a long time. All right, second half underway. The Warriors looking for their first victory of the season. Hampton looking for a share of first place.
And Hampton's staying to a sticking man-to-man. They're just trying to disrupt any kind of offense the Warriors can get. But nice bank shot that time using the board. Marlon Hicks.
Hicks with his first points of the game, and the lead is cut to 11.
Kickatan just hanging around there.
To Ronald Curry, guarded by Haggard, and Curry gets the roll.
Oh man, this kind of snuck in there.
It did. It rolled ever so gently into the hoop. Jernigan. Picked up by Chambliss. Hicks way outside, guarded by Johnny Story. Now Jernigan at the baseline. Down low for Hicks, and Hicks is fouled before the shot. That'll go against Story.
And I tell you, he has really given up, I would venture to say, at least 50 pounds.
Player control foul. Not in the act of shooting. Marshall Haggard will trigger from the baseline. And it's stolen. Ronald Curry. Foot race. Oh, a spinning jam shot off the rim and did not go down. Jernigan on the follow-up is called for the foul. That'll be his 4th. So Curry with the, watch this now, you're going to see Curry tried to do a spectacular jam. It did not go down, but he got his own loose ball rebound in the corner. Loose ball underneath.
Tipped in, but Bobby Blizzard finally got the tip in. You've got some...
I got some fans I'd like to have sit down if they can. That would really help. Thank you. Loose ball picked up by Hicks, and Hicks will gently lay it in. That's two baskets quickly for Marlon Hicks.
Nigel Hager got a hand on that ball to cause a turnover.
And Douglas can't find the iron, and back come the Crabbers. Chris Reeks with the loose ball. Ronald Curry with a nice move to the basket.
He just is so quick and fluid, he's by you before you get a chance to get in defensive position.
Jernigan playing with four fouls is hounded by Curry, and Curry does all he could to get the ball, but couldn't come up with it. Hey, the players play with such reckless abandon, you can just almost visualize them crashing into the stands.
But yeah, but they don't. I mean, and that's the athleticism that they have.
48-33, this is Haggard to Jernigan. Got a pick, spots the open man, Douglas, and Douglas puts it down. And Douglas with six. Travers up by 13. Curry picked up by Haggard. Weeks looks down low, gets Blizzard at the free throw line, kicks it back out to Weeks, the left-hander, hits a three-pointer for Chris Weeks. Pierre Lipford thought about the three, now kicks it outside for Jernigan. Now Douglas will try the three, off the rim, no good, and Johnny Story clears the board.
Marlon Hicks did all he could that time. He had a body on him, but he just couldn't keep him away from the ball.
Curry pulls up, shoots, does not get it, but he'll get a couple of free throws.
And I think they're going to charge Haggard for the foul.
Yep, Marshall Haggard is guilty of the personal foul. And we'll get some substitutions now as Revis Conrad brings Porter back in along with Robbie Simmons. And number 42, that's Willie Sherman. So those three players, along with Douglas and Lipford, are the five on the floor for the Kickitan Warriors. Ronald Curry cans the free throw. For the Crabbers, they've got Chambliss, Curry, Blizzard, Weeks, and Story. 53-35, 4:25 remaining in the third. Tim Cole and Bob Hintz, hope you're enjoying this contest here on Channel 5. Stolen by Weeks. Could have been called for a foul. He pushed.
Yeah, he kind of used his hand to ward off the defender that time.
Official did not see it, and that's the main part of this conversation is if they don't see it, you can do it all night. 2-on-1 in the lane. Short. Follow shot. Good.
Oh, nice job to stay with the shot. Is that Simmons?
Simmons. Yep. Simmons with his first points of the game. And the Warriors stay within 16. Chambliss' pass is picked off by Lipford. Pierre Lipford, who had 22 points in that overtime loss to Heritage last night. And Douglas had 17 for the Warriors in a double overtime loss. That had to hurt. And over the back, that should go against Willie Sherman. Player control foul. Neither team has committed 17 fouls here in the third period. Down to 3.5 minutes to go in the third. Crabbers up by 16. Ronald Curry will bring it across the timeline. Chambliss for three, gets nothing. And a fortunate break for the Crabbers as it was knocked out of bounds by Kickitan. Martin Tinsley checking in for Chris Weeks on Hampton's side. Oh, three. Curry can't get it to stay down. Tinsley kicks it out for Curry. In the lane, shovels it up, no good. The tip is good. I'm not sure who got the hand on that.
I think Ronald Curry got that.
It was. Well, until otherwise corrected, we will we'll give him credit for the basket. It could have been he or Tinsley or Woodard. Willie Sherman's shot is short. Curry. Down low, and too hot to handle as it comes off the hands of Woodard. Ed Douglas took some steps.
Yeah, he just, I think he lost control of a little bit as he went up that time.
Grabbers bring in Marlon Burt for the first time, number 50. He'll come in and replace Bobby Blizzard. Baseline jumper.
Oh, what a tough shot. Almost behind the backboard.
That is a tough
when he
shot.
Went up to shoot the ball.
There you saw it. 20 points is the difference. Lipford just inside the three-point mark. Connects.
He had to work to get open. When he got open, he got his body square. Nice follow through.
Curry can't get it to go down, and the Crabbers lose it on the baseline. Crabbers now will bring Almando Curry back into the game. Let's see who will check out.
I think Ronald is.
Ronald Curry, his cousin.
Walters checks back in also for, who's that? He went in for Sherman?
I believe so. In the corner, Walters off the mark. Douglas kicks it out for Lipford for three. Hit it! Pierre Lipford, and the difference now is 15, just that quickly. Chambliss. Finds the open man for three, and that is Tinsley.
Tinsley, Martin Tinsley, nice looking shot.
Locked inside by Woodard. Back come the Crabbers. Chambliss.
Oh, what body control.
Away by the Crabbers again. So the Warriors just self-destructing here, turning the ball over. Can't give the Crabbers any extra chances. Curry kicks it outside for Tinsley. Back in the lane. Stick back is good by Woodard. There you see him.
Just almost too much physicalness from the Crabbers.
Down to a half a minute to go here in the third. Lipford fakes, shoots, sky ball, and the rainbow didn't drop. Woodard to Chambliss. Oh, the ball won't stay down.
Tim, he got the ball and looked up, and he was almost under the basket. I was surprised he got that good a shot off.
You're right. Woodard with the rebound. I tell you, they got some formidable rebounding when you put Blizzard and Woodard in there.
Oh, my goodness.
So the Crabbers put 22 points on the board in the third period to just 13 for Kickitan, and that lead went from a 13-point difference to a 22-point lead after three periods. Watch some of the replay here.
And while we watch some of the replay, again, you and I had talked about this in the first game, but how important it is for us when we pick a player of the game that it's very unscientific, but we do get feedback from the kids and from their parents how well these T-shirts and plaques are received. They really look forward to them. And, you know, we always say that Dave Buchwalter and John Roberts are helping us do this, but They do this for free, Tim. They give the plaques for free, and we're talking plaques that probably run you about $25, and the sheet T-shirt with engraving, you know, it was screen printing. So, again, if you are in need of engraving or athletic goods, you know, these are the people to look for.
And you need two really good camera people. Three if you throw in Ron Bates. You saw Susie Bowers on one camera and Nathaniel Braxton on the other. And, of course, our ever-present floor camera guy, that's his shot you're looking at right there, Ron ESPN Bates. Good as always, their great job. Bianca Petaway working the graphics for us tonight as Brian Walker hits his second basket. Bev Penn working the instant replay for you, and Scotty Bevia Bowers, our director, producer, and vice president of Channel 5. I'm giving him that title, by the way.
I hear you.
In the lane.
And I haven't heard Scotty deny it.
He didn't deny it. He said, if elected, I will serve. Well, our crew, as always, doing a great job giving up their Saturday night so that you can enjoy high school sports at its best. The Peninsula District, whether it's baseball, football, basketball, softball, you are looking at the best. Martin Tinsley getting set to come back in for the Crabbers as Walter Brower again continues to substitute. His team with a comfortable 19-point lead right now, 66-47. We're down to 7 minutes to go. Haggard has it knocked out of bounds by Blizzard.
Well, he got by Blizzard on the drive, but when you went up and Blizzard's right behind you, he couldn't get the shot off. He needed to go under the basket and maybe use the rim and the backboard to help protect him.
Up the Crabbers. Chambliss with a great burst of speed. This kid is real impressive.
I tell you, Aaron is playing a great game tonight. Chambliss, he's just a junior. He'll be back next year along with just about everybody else. The only seniors that Walter has, one of the starters, is Weeks. He's got Martin Tinsley, of course, is a senior. And Jim Woodard, that's it. Three seniors on this team.
They'll have some say-so in the Peninsula District Tournament before this season is over with two. Foul is called on Curry, I believe. That would be his third.
Yeah, you got the standings there. What are they, a game and a half or half a game behind?
Yeah, they're just a half, and of course with them.
Now, catching, if they win this game, then there's going to be a tie for first place.
Exactly,
here.
They'll tie Mintzville for first, and Phoebus will be in third, followed by Bethel. So three of the four Hampton City schools are in the top four.
And you know, people were saying that only one Hampton school was going to make it in the top five or six teams this year. So good coaching on the part of the Hampton school coaches. Craig Breon over Bethel and David Blizzard, his first year at Phoebus, is doing a good job.
Ball won't stay down. Ben Douglas on the offensive board, got the basket and is fouled. Foul is against Tinsley. Ed Douglas will go to the free throw line as Blizzard will check back out for Hampton. Weeks is back in. Again, Walter Brower stretching that bench out. Likes to give a lot of playing time to a lot of players. And it comes back to be a good, friendly choice later on in the season when these kids have gotten that experience. Michael Curry.
How quick he gets down the court, and you can't get in front of him.
Ball kicked, and that'll go back to the Warriors. 5:39 remaining in the fourth quarter, 72-52.
We got a timeout.
Timeout. I think it was a TV timeout, I think. I saw the young lady cross over there. TV timeout.
Okay. We're getting a little more pull all the time, aren't we? As we look at some of the fans here in attendance at Kickitan High, and you and I we feel like this is home. This is your home away from home. This is our third game. And
I didn't know how to break this to you, but I'm moving in, Bob. You live
well, I tell you, Leonard Thomas has done a great job of helping us out here. And you know, he says, listen, I appreciate you all coming over here, but can you go to another school for a while? And so we will. Tuesday, we will go to Phoebus and have the they will host the Bethel Bruins, and that'll be a good contest.
Yes, it will. Those are two really fine basketball teams. I was very impressed with Phoebus the last time I watched them, and I was impressed with Bethel. So these two squads that throw Hampton into the mix, and Kickitan's struggling along here, but Hampton, Bethel, and Phoebus, they're going to have a lot to say about this Peninsula District Tournament coming up here before too long.
Just wasn't a good pass, a good idea. Marshall Haggard was underneath the basket, wide open, but Kier was double-teamed and couldn't hardly find him.
Blizzard gives the Chambers back to Blizzard to Weeks, and Weeks is stuffed.
And that was by number 14, Tim, and he's only 5'8", Bobby Simmons.
Ben Douglas with a nice move to get to. Chambliss kisses the ball off the glass.
Nice pass by Ronald Curry that time. Could have forced the shot, didn't, made the nice pass. Aaron makes the basket.
22 on the game for Chambliss, and then Haggard stepped on by the sideline there.
Well, you drop that foot back to get a push off, and if you're close to the sideline, you have a tendency to step out of bounds. I'm not laughing at him, but that happens to me. I know that's you say, wait a minute, I wasn't out of bounds.
Chambliss gets the ball up the court so quickly, he is just like grease lightning.
I tell you, and you know, we started talking about people who play the game, you got to look at Ronald Curry and Bobby Blizzard, Aaron Chambliss for sure, Story, Woodard over in Kickitan. You got Douglas is playing a great game. Lifford, of course, Hicks, Porter, Brown, just to mention a few.
Marshall Haggard can't get it to stay down. Ronald Curry cleans it off. Spots Chambliss down there. Alley-oop to Curry.
Oh, that was a beautiful pass from Aaron Chambliss. Oh, they're giving the basket. They're giving the basket, calling goaltending.
So Lipford will get credit for the bucket. And that was a good call, I thought. The ball was coming down off the glass and it was interfered with. Watch your replay here. You'll see Lipford go up and the ball was hit off the glass.
Yeah, but you can hit it off the glass. I'm not too sure that ball was on its way down.
I don't know.
On a replay, it's hard to tell. And of course, underneath the basket, they got to make those calls very quick. The officials do.
15 points unofficially for Lipford. Thirteen for Douglas to pace the Warriors. Underneath for Weeks. Chris Weeks has 7. Give the assist to Curry on that one. In the lane, Jernigan, and he gets the roll as well. So Byron Jernigan gets 2. 78-59, 3:45 to go. Talk about it. No shot clock in high school ball. You don't need a shot clock in these games.
No, you sure don't.
Chambliss is wide open, and that could be dangerous. This time he doesn't connect, however. Pierre Lipford. Nice pass to Haggard, short on the shot. Curry with the rebound. Curry is fouled in the backcourt.
And I believe it was on Haggard. He felt like he should have had that shot. Did a good job putting up with his left hand, just a little too strong.
Watch the replay here.
And that's where he got him.
On the wrist. Clear control foul, as neither team has exceeded the limit here. Stop and shot underneath by
Mondo
Curry.
Muffin.
stolen by Weeks. Jernigan knocks it out of bounds. 80-59, Hampton. It's been all Hampton. They led by 8 after 1, and they led by 13 at halftime, and then built on that lead in the third period and really have never looked back. The Warriors just not strong enough to stay with this Hampton team. Donald Curry kicks it out to Weeks. Shamless.
Hampton just taking some time off the clock, running almost like a spread offense and trying to get an easy basket.
Lipford's shot won't go, and it's knocked out of bounds by Hampton. Well, we're going to pick our players of the game. I'll name the player for Kickitan if you want.
Okay.
I'm going to go along with your thoughts on Ben Douglas. Ben Douglas played a fine game, had 4.5, and has added 9 more for 13 in the game. And of course, Lipford has done a fine job, as several others. Brown did a good job coming in, as did Porter.
Porter really impressed me there in about a 2-minute stretch. He looked like he was All-American out there, but you look at these young men and you got to pick one, and it's hard to come up with one and we're not slighting the others because they didn't get it.
Yep.
And on the Hampton side, I'm going to go with Aaron Chambliss. I think he's just really kind of been a catalyst. You know, you look at the score, you got to say Ronald Curry. He's a Mr. Do-Everything out there, and it's not that we didn't think he did a great job, but we'll go with Aaron Chambliss and Ben Douglas.
22 points unofficially for Chambliss. Got a pair of threes. Got a whistle and a travel before the shot. Chambliss perfect from the free throw line, 4 out of 4.
Well, we want to thank Buckwalter Engraving and the Island of Hardware and Sporting Goods for letting us recognize these two young men.
And we want to thank the fine people here at Kickitan for letting me set up a bunk the last 3 weeks here. Long ride.
You wait till you get the rent due.
My room bill. I didn't have any. I had room, but I didn't have any board. I didn't see any food coming at me.
Ronald Curry. Wow, Ronald Curry almost got a jam. I don't know how he was up in the air, but whew.
Tommy Simmons answered on the other end, 80-61, down to 1:13 to go. Curry is out of control a bit there as he was trying to feed it to Marlon Burke. But the ball was tipped out of bounds by the Warriors. Douglas spots Lipford open, and Lipford will score an easy two. 14, let's see. 17 unofficially in the game for Pierre Lipford, so he's had a good night. Chambliss shuffled the feet. That's a good call.
Yeah, he did. He's trying to get under control and just kind of lost it.
Less than a minute to go now as the Crabbers will, with this victory, tie Menchville for first place as we head down the home stretch in the Peninsula District. Douglas for three, a little short. Rebounded, loose ball. Warriors still have it. Porter. Stolen by Chambliss. And check that out, Chambliss rather, but number 10, Curry, who throws it down court to Chambliss. In the lane, shot won't fall, but the stick back is good by Robbie Simmons. So Simmons has 9 points for Kickitan. And we're down to 10 seconds to go now. Chambliss on the lead pass on the alley-oop, doesn't get it to him. Elmondo Curry in the lane, no good. And we've got a foul underneath with just 1 second remaining.
One
foul.
Click.
Foul on Porter. Again, we remind you, Tuesday night, come on out to Phoebus High School, the Bethel Bruins boys and girls contest. 5:30 for the girls, immediately following that, the boys contest. Come on out and support your favorite team. We'll be there and have it for you right here on Channel 5. Bethel and Phoebus coming up this Tuesday, the 28th. Curry misses the first of two free throws. The only thing in doubt here is the final score. And Curry doesn't get that to fall, and that is going to do it. That will be the final score. 82-65 as the Hampton Crabbers, with the victory, earn a share of first place along with the Mensville Monarchs.
And I tell you, Kickatan Warriors put up a great battle, Tim. They are the best 0-13 team I've seen in a long, long time. They never give up. They work hard. They try to come up. But when you are going against a team that's just superior athletes, and you don't have a quarterback on the floor to help you run yours, it makes a big difference.
The final score, the Hampton Crabbers 82, the Kickatan Warriors 65. I want to thank Wood Funeral Home for helping us with sponsorship tonight. Richard Pulley is the funeral director over there. And the Hampton Crabbers, there you see that
Mr. Wood
Hampton
right here.
High School National Football Championship sweatshirt that's on sale over
there.
Yeah,
Mr. That's Wood had one on too. I was going to get the camera on it, but Ron picked it up already. He said they were going like hotcakes over in Hampton.
Okay. That's going to do it from Kickatan High School. See you Tuesday night. The final score, 82-65. Hampton victorious. For Bob Hintz and the entire Channel 5 crew, this is Tim Cole. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.